If any of our sports people combined the will to be the best with exceptional talent, it's Sir Richard Hadlee. His handwritten motivational notes, evidence of the competitor within. Today, another line to add to the rich script. Let's go live to Jordan Oppert, who's been part of a very special day at Hagley Park.
Yes, very special and very emotional. This is a project that spanned the best part of two decades. And while it wouldn't have been possible if Heather and Stephen Bock hadn't have perched the Horticultural Centre when they did, it was the man it's named after who was centre stage today.
There's a twinkle in the eye as our greatest test bowler takes us around the state-of-the-art facility.
It completes the whole Hagley precinct.
But while this might be the Sir Richard Hadlee Centre, it's never been about him.
What does it mean to you?
Well, this is a community facility. It's there for boys, girls, schools, club, whatever group or individual wants to use it.
The main feature, 5 3.6-metre wide cricket lanes.
They're all set up, obviously, for use at the moment, but one person can pull these all the way back. So four of these nets can just go right back to the far end. And opens up the floor space for other sporting activities.
Versatile and practical, its amenities are gender neutral.
Even in this one, you get two teams in here easily. Four showers, and obviously they're private as well, which sort of helps. In the old days, it was just sort of free for all in the showers, really.
Have you tested the pressure?
No, I haven't yet. I could do, but the cameraman might not be too impressed.
There's been no expense spared from the nearly $5 million fundraised, as recognised on the stairwell wall.
The bigger the ball, the greater the donation. So we have this one here that my trust has donated $800,000. It's just a lovely feature. It adds vibrancy, warmth and energy to what's inside here.
Up here's a 300-square-metre mezzanine floor lined by honours boards. The space filled with meeting rooms, boardrooms, Canterbury Cricket's new office.
Look at that.
Not bad, eh? The only problem with Test cricket, of course, is that marquees go up the front here.
Oh, but, we might have to rearrange that.
Yeah, but for first-class cricket, you can see exactly what's going on.
With the tour wrapped up, I just had to ask.
These are full-length cricket pitches, aren't they?
Oh, including the 20.12 metres from wicket to wicket. I could have got my old full run-up into it. These days, I need that far. So it's not a problem for me.
Well, go on.
You don't want to embarrass me, do you?
I would never do that, Sir Richard. Never would I do that.
How's that?
Sir Richard was in good form today. In fact, the best I've seen him for quite some time. As publicly known, he's really battled with his health, stage 4 colorectal cancer, for a start. In fact, the first story I did with him, he said he'd just hope he'd live to see today. That was 2 years ago. So that the fact he was here today is a miracle in itself. And I can confirm they've had their first booking. And with winter training just around the corner, I'm sure it won't be the last.
Thanks, Jordan Offit. That is Jordan, live outside the Sir Richard Hadlee Sports Centre.